Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I'm your host, Jason Turner. In this episode, I'm going to talk about a feature from C++ 20, which has surprising utility. Be sure to check out the video description for links to my ebooks, printed books, Patreon, and GitHub sponsor page, as well as news about upcoming events that you might be interested in. Now, I think I can actually say this is going to be a very short episode. I know I often start episodes with that statement and then they end up being not very short. So this is feature test macros from C++ 20, and you can find it here in cbpreference.com as always. C++ 20 standardized something that many compilers were already doing. And in a way, it's a little ironic that this was only added in C++ 20 because we could have used it certainly during the development of 11, 14, and 17 as well. But what this does is it gives you a compile time way of asking, does this feature exist in the standard? And every single feature added from C++ 11 forward has been put in here. So you can even ask at compile time, does a certain attribute exist? Or are binary literals added? And this is also an interesting way of just kind of discovering things that were added to the standard and when. We can see here that was added in C++ 14. And this value is the year and month that the proposal is actually accepted into the standard. So we can see attributes were actually accepted in 2008. Some of the things that are slightly more surprising perhaps are like delegating constructors from 2006. And every now and then you'll stumble upon a paper from C++ 20 that was actually accepted very early on in the proposal process, such as this thing from 2017, explicit template parameter list for generic lambdas, which is a feature that I've covered on C++ Weekly. So I guess, you know, right now, you could take a moment and comment and say, well, you haven't done a feature on X yet. We would like to see that feature covered in an episode of C++ Weekly. So feel free to comment on that in the comment section. Although, do look to see if I've done an episode on it already, if you can take a moment to do that. Okay, so this isn't actually complicated, but it does cover everything. Everything from C++ 11 forward. So I made use of this for the first time recently. I have mentioned my tools repository a few times over the last couple of months, and it's just a place where I've been putting things. And one of the things that we covered in a relatively recent episode was this static views. This was that episode on the C++ Constexpr problem that took me 5 years to solve. So I have this static views header file here, and this is how all the things are implemented. This is done in a generic way. It can be used with any C++ 20 compiler, but not every C++ 20 compiler supports all of the features of C++ 20 yet. And I have my test here, my static views tests. And we can see down in here that I have this feature test macro, if cpp lib constexpr string. So I'm asking, does the standard library I'm currently using support constexpr string usage? And you can see here, I checked to see if it's greater than equal to 2019.07. I did not check for exact equality, because it's entirely possible that there will be multiple versions of this value in the future if there's a future upgrade to constexpr string or something like that. So I just look for, is it this value or greater? And if it is, then I know that I can do tests that require constexpr string. And it's 2022, right now, and I am trying to use a C++ 20 feature. With C++ 20 compilers, I pretty much only support the latest compilers here. So you might ask, well, why is this even necessary? Let's just go ahead and go to our handy compiler support table from cppreference.com, and we can scroll down here to C++ 20 features. And here we go. We can see that actually libc++ is lagging a bit behind in C++ 20 library features. So I wanted to support as many compilers as I could, as best as I could. And we can see here for Constexpr String and Constexpr Vector, we have full support in Visual Studio and GCC, but not yet in Clang. So this lets me compile my test on all the platforms, although with a slightly reduced test set when compiling on Clang with libc++. So there you go. This is the C++ feature test macros from C++ 20. So before wrapping this up, I decided to go ahead and do a quick review of how and where and if actually checking that value matters to me. And we can see here in this CPP Constexpr feature macro, we actually have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 different possible values that it can be. So if all I care is that some minimal amount of C++ 11 Constexpr support exists, then I can check for greater than or equal to 2704. If I care that we've got all of the features of non-literal variables, labels, go-to statements, etc. from C++ 23, then I'll need to check for this value or greater. So I do not think that I did overkill by checking for greater than or equal to the particular number that I care about for that particular feature. So check this out if you need it. You know, hopefully you can avoid it because this does rely on using the C++ preprocessor. But it's there, it's a tool if you need it.